It's my pleasure to introduce to you all Sue Gale, the owner of Fairfield Nutrition, as this year's Chamber the sponsor there. Everybody, please look at that. So our president, Sue Gale.
There was so much success this year. I'm really excited to be able to present to you tonight the 2015 year in review. I'm going to start off with some of the highlights that the Chamber itself presented to all of you. You know, the mission of the Chamber is to connect our members and to engage our community and prosper together. And we started off by connecting members in many ways last year. One of the great things is that we have access to many people, not only locally, but around the country. So we had Jim Bagnola presenting Become a Professional Human Being. We had the Indian Hills Community College bringing your A game to work. We had speed networking. All of these things are designed to help our businesses from every level to connect from employee to CEO. And our goal in 2016 is to bring roundtables, trainings that cover topics that are pertinent to every aspect of your business. And also, we're engaging the community, especially this year, in connecting with the Visitors Bureau and the Fairfield Economic Development Association, the city, many different components, to bring together this branding initiative that really, for the Chamber members, we expect to help provide, you know, new business opportunities, increased business opportunities, and it's very, very comprehensive in its scope. So every member of our community should be able to benefit from it. And secondly, we're very proud to have our leadership Fairfield this second year, where the leadership actually from the previous year were the ones that led the initiative this year. So we're going to be experiencing their graduation here tonight. And then Prospering Together has launched our beautiful new website. I know some of you are familiar with it. Many of you may not know how much in depth it will be going for you. So we have special seminars set up for you. And we also have our new Jefferson County map. They've been delivered to lots of the businesses, but you can pick up some more. And we continue to offer the member to member. Those of you that use it know how much variety it has, but you as a member or your business employees are eligible to participate in this. And if you have a business, we want to be able to help you to increase the traffic and the benefit to your business using that. And oh, there we go. We value innovation and Fairfield's unique assets. So I want to have everyone that is on our Ambassadors Club, please stand up, be recognized, and everyone, hats off to them. They were deputized to be our greeters tonight. They're also visiting all of our new members. And the ones with the shiny badges, my posse, would you all please stand up? The board of directors. They spend many hours volunteering their time to figure out how to run this rodeo called the Chamber. And we also have some retiring members I'd like to recognize. Seth Miller of Cambridge Investment, Ken Ross of Global ID, Laura Atwood of the Fairfield Public Schools, Don Bechtel of Golf Links to the Past, and Josie Hannes of Flair. So if you're here, would you please stand? And yes, I know I missed one. We have the Chamber past presidents who really deserve a round of applause. So if you are here tonight as a past president, would you please stand up? Clap again. And I'd like to bring up last year, 2015 and 2014's past president, Michael Halley. He's from Danaher Oil. He did an amazing job for us. I want to thank you for your guidance and your vision and your leadership for these last 2 years, Michael. You have a lifetime membership with the chamber, you know. So to honor him, we want to thank you for your service and passing on the baton. Oh, no, it's not a baton. What do you pass on in a rodeo?
Lasso.
A lasso, okay. So, thank you so much. Do we have? Bet you were wondering, huh? There we go. Walk this way. All right. And onward. 2016, the big news. Our longstanding executive director, Nancy Morrissey, is retiring after 23 years. She has been the face of the chamber. Oh, there she is. At all our events, behind the scenes, in the scene, making a scene. So she is our rodeo queen, our rose. We'd like to have you just come up and get the applause you deserve for the last 23 years. I just want to say there's going to be a big hoedown for her, so stay tuned.
And no rodeo is complete, as Sue said, unless we have our own rodeo queen. And Nancy, this horse is going to kill me back here, is trying to trip me, but you are our rodeo queen.
Thank you, everyone. It's been a glorious, glorious run, and you're all friends, and I love you all. Thank you.
Okay, so the chamber is now in the process of rounding up a new chamber executive, so stay tuned for that. To have our shared vision of leading our business community to greater success continue in the next however many years. So now I'm going to turn the program back over to our rodeo boss and celebrate all of you. Thank you.
John bought Nancy some beautiful yellow roses. Can you hold them up? Yeah, it's sweet. He was asking about the handcuffs, though, just so you know. They're not for sale, John. Well, now it's time to introduce Jolene Parker and Bart Kness. They're known by their cowboy names tonight. Actually, it's Jolene Jonna Wayne Parker. But before I do that, I've been asked as a free service to all members, chamber members, to visit with you about this year's presidential race. First, if we as a nation really want to save taxpayer dollars, we should elect a woman. You're supposed to clap, ladies. Because according to Hillary, they get paid 23% less than guys would. So that appears to me the best deal money-wise. That is Hillary. You know, Hillary would be really proud of our own Jolene Parker. As you know, Jolene recently demanded at work that she be paid the same as her husband, Gene. So they cut her pay, and she was replaced by a piano. Better than that ATM, right, Gene? Feel the burn. Well, I don't know. But I do know that he is the most interesting candidate in the world. Bernie doesn't always drink beer, but when he does, it's somebody else's. I hear that Bernie is so serious that he doesn't even make fun of himself at his own expense. You know what, though? I really think I could vote for Cruz. Penelope. I could. Not Tom. But I really like the Donald the best. Better than Mickey. Minnie. Or Goofy. Although Ted did announce, if elected president, he would change his name to Uncle Scrooge. That's helped you people, right? Yeah. Good, good. That was just another public service from the chambers. Chamber. Now, please welcome Bart and Jolene to the stage to present this year's Business Improvement Awards, known this year as Making Fairfield Great Again.
Oh, there is so darn much good stuff going on in Fairfield that it's almost difficult to know where to start. And you know, but I do have to say, I was thinking tonight of kind of spoofing him a little bit about being Slim Pickens, or, but Woody come to mind? Oh, welcome, welcome. So let's, tonight for our Business Improvement Awards, we'd like the recipients to come across the stage from the west side to Aaron, and then if they would meet, Nancy, right down here on the edge, we'd like to get some pictures, and Lindsay's the post for where you get on it. Tonight's first Business Improvement Award goes to Agri-Industrial Plastics Company. Jeff Ward is accepting the award tonight. These folks just have forgotten not to keep growing. And they are growing and growing and growing. And this year, you know, last year we told them that Fairfield X was going to be out there because planes are thinking it's an airport. But they've added another 8,000 square feet for their shop, I think. Isn't that right? Congratulations to Agri-Industrial and Plastics. Our second award goes to Edward Jones Investments, and Connie Boyer is accepting. Edward Jones has had a strong position in our community for a very long time, and Connie has opened her own shop at this point. She took some raw space and designed it and outfitted it, and we welcome her to our investment crew for the city. Congratulations, Connie. Now, the folks that helped this happen are our next recipients, Elite Tire and Auto. Jeremy Miller is here to accept their award. Jeremy took a very large space and retrofit it for his business, as well as some really good things for the kids, I understand. He has Heather with him tonight. And we're excited that they have done this and made the space wonderfully functional for them and for Connie. Our next recipient is Fairfield Dental Clinic, and they've had a major overhaul, and I do mean major if you start at the roof and go down, but the people inside kind of had a major overhaul too. We lost our Steve Van Tassel, he retired, and we got Dr. Pat Jones, Dr. Marty Gleason. They are, you know, and we have Denise there too. These folks, they changed everything. There they go. Usually they have me upside down with my mouth open. So we congratulate them. Everything is new over there. All the interiors, exterior, it all. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing for us, for our town, to have all of this going on. Next is the Fairfield Golf and Country Club. Here's another area that's done a bunch in the field of facelifting. Tonight we have Wendy Marmion and Linda Pettit accepting. Linda was the designer, and Wendy was our trail boss for this. The interior has a wonderful new facelift, and there is a huge new outdoor space for all of the functions that can go on out there through all sorts of seasons, because they have heaters and everything else. Now, I will tell you, they're laying on their sides because of the wind right now, but, you know, maybe we can get them up and light them sometime. And talk about having some fun. Our Flirt Clothing Boutique moved. They got their own space and have had a ball getting it outfitted. Julie Greason and Tracy Hammes are here tonight to accept this award. They have been very active in our town, and they have done it upright. So, guys, get out there and check out Flirt. The girls already know about it. Our next one's pretty near and dear to me, Jefferson County Health Center. When we're talking about growth, it just keeps happening there. And this past year's big event was the opening of the walk-in clinic out at the campus. They'll be back again next year because groundbreaking is starting on the next big project. Deb Carden is here to accept this award, so if Deb can come up, that would be great. I know she's here someplace, or was. Hello. This is how she and I work together. On behalf of, what? Did you find her? Okay. Anyway, there'll be big news there because she'll be retiring at the end of the month as well. Big changes. Keosauqua Lumber Company is our next recipient, and tonight we had Fred Shappy with us to accept this award, and they have totally redone indoor and outdoor, and it's mighty fine to have a lumber yard, another one here in town, where we can get the things that we need, so we're pretty darn happy to have them. Mike and Nikki's is having one busy Friday night, and anybody who's been by there recently and sees that there are no parking places would understand why. They have totally refurbished everything, ceiling to floor in their business, and they apologize for not being here, but they're working tonight. We have Natel Broadband, and I was thinking Mike Schill's here to accept this award. In my business, a broadband might be something we'd wrap around your chest if you broke your ribs or something like that. But I'm pretty sure that's not what they're doing. It does mention a whole lot of words in a different language here. They have done a lot of things like upgrading their network to a 10 gig ring, and they have I don't know. They have a whole lot of other words here, too, that I may just leave on the paper. But the bottom line is they've expanded into Centerville, and they've increased their revenues by 18%, all coming back to our town. Then we have the Platinum Salon and Spa, who have taken a shelled space and made it their own too. Abby Snowgren is here tonight to accept this award. Abby's very busy beautifying our community and helping with the Fair Queens and Special Olympics and a whole lot of things. So we are really, really happy to have her here with us. Then Washington State Bank has built a new facility in our town, and Steve Bone is here. By the way, I called them to find out how you say it for sure. They told me it's just like femur. You're good. There you go, Steve. So we welcome our new bank to our town. Really glad to have you here. Really, really glad. And I think that concludes that particular section. Are you ready for me to move my stuff?
Why do cowboys die with their boots on? Because they don't want to stub their toes when they kick the bucket. Next, we have a really special treat. It's called the Boot Scootin' Boogie.
Past the city limit sign, where there's a honky-tonk near the county line. The joint starts jumping every night when the sun goes down. They got whiskey, women, music, and smoke. It's where all the cowboy folk go to boot scoot boogie. I got a good job, I work hard for my money. When it's quitting time, I hit the door running, I fire up my pickup truck and let the horses run. I go flying down that highway to that hideaway, struck out in the woods to do the boot scoot boogie. Yeah, he told Do-si-do, come on baby, let's go boot scoot. What'll it be? I want a shot of that redhead yonder looking at me. The dance floor's hopping and it's hotter than the 4th of July. I see outlaws, in-laws, crooks and straights, all out making it shake, doing the boot scoot boogie. Yeah, heel toe, do-si-do, come on baby, let's go.
Well, that was a surprise. You know, maybe it's just me, but do you think it'd be nice if the podium had like a drink holder? Maybe next year. Now our president, Sue City Sue, will be presenting the Fairfield Leadership Graduation. Is it an award? Just graduation? Anyway.
I love our chamber board. I can get them to do anything. Boot scooting hopefully was one of the more fun things. But now I'm really excited about the Leadership Fairfield. So tonight, we're going to be honoring the graduates of this program that started last fall and completed just last week, where monthly people from all of the businesses in town that want to know what leadership is and what it is in Fairfield got to meet monthly, a program designed to educate and inspire and connect those people that are interested in further developing their leadership skills. And each one-day seminar took on a different aspect of community, quality of life, local government and public safety, communications and finance, health and human services, business and entrepreneurship, education, agriculture, and sustainability. And the participants spearheaded community projects to demonstrate leadership in action. So for example, insert glasses here. As a new member of the Fairfield community, Leadership Fairfield has provided me with the knowledge and confidence to become a community member. These traits have also allowed me to give back to the community, which is something I value very much. Thank you, Jess Jones, professional clinic manager at the Jefferson County Health Center. Leadership Fairfield is a must attend program for any business leader who is interested in learning more about our community and its offerings. It's well worth the investment of individual time and company sponsorship to attend. The combination of diverse leaders who participated in the program, as well as the first-rate program mentors, Nancy Morrissey, Lindsay Waugh, and Ashley Moyer, along with the various panels and company tour guides, made for a great program experience. I am very proud and honored to be a Leadership Fairfield graduate. Novana Cole, Director of Accounting, Hawthorne Direct. And finally, Leadership Fairfield allowed me to learn about the community and network with fellow business leaders. Being new to the community, it was an invaluable experience. Patrick Jones, dentist at Fairfield Dental. So again, tonight we are very honored and proud to present the graduation certificates to the following people, and you can hold your applause till the end. First, we have Novana Cole from Hawthorne Direct. Jason Davis, Agra Industrial Plastics Company. Katie Dennison, Fairfield Arts and Convention Center. Christina Hamm, Cambridge Investment Research Incorporated. Trent Hammes, Dexter Laundry Incorporated. Ayako Kwong, Miami University of Management. Mauricio University of Management. Jessica Jones, Jefferson County Health Center. Pat Jones, Fairfield Dental Clinic. Clint Keller, Bob's Automotive Incorporated. Sabrina Kirka, MidWestOne Bank. Gretchen Laley Jens, Youth Can Move the World. Kay Osvig, Cambridge Investment Research Incorporated. Will Regnier, Fairfield Line. Diana Rivera, Mauricio University of Management. Mary Shearson, Iowa State Bank and Trust Company. Vanessa Willman, Foss, Quicken and Cochran, PC. Martha Wick, Indian Hills Community College. And Aaron Yettersberger, local internet sales company, otherwise known as Lisco. Please give them all a huge applause.
So we'll get right into the awards. This year's Green Business Improvement Award, presented by Global ID Group, goes to Libertyville Savings Bank. Libertyville Savings Bank is very involved with supporting all of the communities they do business in. In 2015, their employees volunteered over 600 hours of personal time towards community projects and causes. The solar panel project, the hand dryers, are just a few more ways of doing the right thing. Conserve energy and protect our environment. And if you haven't been over by the new Fairfield renovation and seen their solar project. It is very impressive. Accepting the award on behalf of Libertyville Savings Bank is Mr. Ryan Troutman, and presenting the award for Global ID is Mr. Ken Norton. The 2016 Impact Award, presented by Cambridge Investment Research, is awarded to First National Bank and Trust. First National Bank has called this beautiful community home for the past 150 years. Been celebrating an anniversary, if you haven't noticed. Serving area families, farmers, and business leaders, part of being a community bank means supporting local initiatives and organizations. And First National Bank in Fairfield proudly supports local organizations throughout the year, whether it's through financial donations to community causes or through staff volunteering both time and talents. They believe that by supporting local organizations, they make our community a better place for all who call it home. The hardworking professionals at First National Bank are committed to putting customers first and continue to provide financial services and economic stability to the Fairfield community. They truly make an impact. Accepting the award on behalf of First National Bank is Pat Hurley, my friend Pat Hurley, the distinguished president and CEO, and awarding the prestigious Impact Award is Dan Sullivan from Cambridge. Congratulations. The next award, the Interactive Media Award, is presented by Hawthorne Direct. It goes to a business that is near and dear to me, Creative Edge Master Shop. Creative Edge has been an enthusiastic supporter of the arts in Fairfield since 1988. The company's involvement includes sponsoring school and dance performances, civic and decorative projects, such as the Fairfield Civic Center and decorative lobby. And they're the primary sponsor of the Creative Edge Film Fest. Accepting the award on behalf of Creative Edge Master Shop is owner and president Jim Bellalove. And presenting the award from Hawthorne Direct is their CFO, Steve Jurgensen. This year's New Young Business Award is presented by Sunnybrook Living Care Center, and it goes to Impact Fitness and Sports Performance. Impact Fitness offers an avenue for the community to improve their overall fitness and health through a variety of services, corporate wellness programs, and fitness assessments. From the day their doors opened, Impact's mission has been to provide exceptional fitness and sports performance training in a positive and supportive atmosphere. Using the impact of exercise in addition to other healthy behaviors, Impact strives to educate, equip their clients with the tools and techniques to enhance their quality of life. As a client, I can personally attest to their expertise, professionalism, and they even manage to have some fun if you see the photo where everyone is dressed up. That's a typical Tuesday morning. Accepting the award tonight for Impact Fitness are the co-owners, Danny and Brady Hill, and presenting the award for Sunnybrook Living Care Center, Betty Howell, owner and CEO, and Tom Elston, the general manager.
Our next award is the Progress Award, and it is sponsored by First National Bank. Pat Hurley will be presenting the award. It recognizes chamber member businesses that have shown significant growth to their business or commitment to their community. This year's recipient is Fairfield Parks and Recreation, and Mayor Ed Malloy will be accepting. No need worrying about tallying all the things they've done, and we'll be seeing them again next year, I'm guessing, too. Our next award is called the Rising Star Award. It's sponsored by Danaher Oil, and Ed Malloy will be presenting this award. It recognizes a chamber business member in their second or third year who've made outstanding contributions to Fairfield. And this year's recipient is Werner Elmker of Werner Elmker Audiovisual Studio. And he's the man around town. This is the gentleman who is capturing all of Fairfield's life around the city. You see him everywhere. The next award is the Wellness Award, and it recognizes chamber members who serve as role models for health and wellness. Jefferson County Health Center is the sponsor, and Deb Carden will be presenting this award. This year, the award goes to iGymnastics, and I was thinking maybe that Jeff was going to be here to accept it, but I think he has a great fill-in for us tonight. These folks have done an incredible job, not only in working with people of all ages, but they're also bringing lots of traffic into our town, I think, with the functions that they're having, so we thank them in lots of ways. This year, we're really, really pleased to have two Community Improvement Awards. This award does recognize businesses that have demonstrated a marked contribution to our community during the year prior to this banquet. Our first recipient is the Fairfield Community School Systems. The awards are sponsored by Foss, Kiken, and Cochran. Vanessa Williams will be presenting them, and on behalf of the schools, Dr. Lori Knoll and Jennifer Anderson. Vanessa, whoever, Willman. Sorry about that. So, goes without saying, anybody who's been by the high school knows everything that they're doing there to make it a premier place to learn while maintaining that nostalgia and the spirit that brought the high school to where it is. Congratulations. The Mosden Barnes Museum and Welcome Center will be the second recipient. As we were saying, they have done tremendous things in beefing up those historic barns, moving a home for a welcome center. But this year, they built a whole new building to be able to expand the facility to highlight historic pieces from Fairfield's. I knew it. I knew. You know, he's been waiting months for this opportunity, and he thinks there's nothing I can do to him, but he's wrong, because I'll be there in the night at his house. Tony Webb is here to receive that, for those of you who didn't recognize him. And I think that brings us back to our sponsor.
Next, we have the James Gang. That's right. James Saltz and James Edgeton. And they're going to present the Outstanding Citizen Community Service Award. First, Jim Saltz.
Woo! Doggies! Boy, we got some fine looking women out there tonight, don't we? Got to add a little levity to this. I was going to tell a joke, but we'll make it short. When I was chosen last year of one of the recipients of the Citizen of the Year Award, I was really caught by surprise. My wife, Joan, pulled the perfect ruse to have me attend the banquet. She said that the Fairfield Area Community Theater was going to get an award that night, and because she was a board member, we had to attend. So naturally, I said, okay, no problem. They didn't get an award, and I thought nothing of it until I recognized I was receiving one of the awards when Stacy Wright started her presentation. Your mind kind of goes blank then, but I do remember that I said this was a great place to live and be part of this community. Several people congratulated me, and I thanked them. But then I also told them that there are many others in the community that are just as deserving. We have so many people who volunteer their time, talents, resources, and finances that aren't given the credit they deserve. As I look around the room tonight, I see the community as a whole You people are what makes Fairfield, Iowa, a great place. The person sitting next to you probably volunteers more than you realize. Maybe they play in the municipal band, coach baseball or football, sing in a church choir, teach Sunday school, serve on a board, have been involved in one of the community theater productions, play an instrument in the orchestra, organize fundraisers for worthy causes, call on shut-ins, take people to doctor's appointment, or make a daily phone call to someone just to check on them to see how they are. The list could go on, but the point I want to make is that they all volunteer without any expectation of personal or financial gain, and that's what makes Fairfield a great place to live and raise a family. So with that, give yourself and the person next to you a round of applause, because all of you deserve to be thanked and recognized for doing great things in this community. I was a member of the Fairfield Rotary Club for over 20 years, and when I was a member, we recited at the end of every meeting what is called the Rotary four-way test. It goes like this. Is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned? As I tell you about the first recipient, keep those four statements in mind. The first recipient of this award is a person who has demonstrated throughout all their life a commitment to all of these principles. Although not born in Jefferson County, this person has called it home for more than half their life. In this person's professional career, maybe you or someone in your family would have had a great appreciation for their skill and expertise. This person is still married to the same spouse, and between their skills and talents have brought smiles to countless individuals in this community. Prior to this marriage, the young lady was attending an all-girls school in Mississippi, and the love-struck boyfriend made a trip to see her. Shortly after that time, the equally love-struck girlfriend returned to Iowa to complete her education. The rest of the story continues with a marriage of 56 years, two children, and eight grandchildren. When this person has done volunteer work, his spouse has also been there helping many of the times. Not only has this person volunteered their time and talents locally, but also used his skills in other communities and countries to assist those in time of need. This person has helped build several of the Habitat for Humanity homes in Fairfield, and his wife has served on the board and was a volunteer coordinator. For many years, he has assisted in the preparation of the sleigh for Santa when he comes to town on Christmas Eve and make his way to Central Park. Whether it is assembling the sleigh, assisting Santa in Central Park in all types of weather, or putting the sleigh away for the next parade, he can be counted on to be there. He enjoys fishing and can manage the skill of fly fishing. He also plays a little golf, but likes to spend time on his farm and his tractor, and get this, a bulldozer. Now it's time to give you some facts. Born in Mahaska County and grew up in Knoxville, Iowa. A graduate of the University of Iowa and the University of Iowa Dental School. Served in the United States Navy and Naval Reserve as a dental officer. Moved to Fairfield in 1964 and established a dental practice with his wife as a dental hygienist. Served as an adjunct professor at the University of Iowa Dental School for 3 years, has been a member of the Fairfield Rotary Club for 52 years, served as a board member and also president, and as a district chairman of World Community Service for Rotary International. Through the Rotary Club, he has traveled to Mexico to provide dental service to needy people and to Cartagena, Colombia, with his son to work in a hospital. With his wife, Janet, and the Methodist Church Group, traveled to Mississippi after Hurricane Katrina to help repair homes, and also to Iowa City after those floods to repair homes. He has been a member of the Jefferson County Trails from its inception in 1997, has worked long and hard on virtually every segment of the trail project and helping build every one of the trail bridges. Working beside him on the last bridge at Walton Lake in sub-freezing cold showed me how committed he was to seeing any and every project completed. He helped install the kiosks and public art on the Loop Trail and acquire a much-needed easement to connect Lamson Woods to Chautauqua Park. He was the chairman of the Mosden Barns Preservation Committee from 2007 to 2012 and continues to serve on the board. Through his leadership, knowledge, and vision, he helped transform this historical site into a tourism and educational center of early Iowa agriculture, which includes the Loudon Machinery Company, Turney Wagon Works, and the story of the Mosden family and how Pershing horses were used in every aspect of 19th and 20th century rural life. When we were making the house into a museum and living quarters for the caretakers, he was there with his tools and carpentry skills. When it came time to refinish the hardwood floors, he was there on his hands and knees putting on the four coats of finish. Working to restore the barns and label displays contained would not have been possible without his assistance. A few years ago, the louvers on the cupola of the Mare Barn were not quite right color for the Historical Society. On a November morning, with frost on the roof, he was on the roof painting them the right color so a picture could be taken and submitted to the Historical Society. He has devoted countless hours, talents, and financial resources in all his endeavors and truly embodies the tenets of the Rotary motto of service above self. Unfortunately, our recipient is not able to be with us tonight, but with the help of Ron Blair, we have been able to live feed it to our Citizen of the Year and surprise him. It is my honor to announce the Citizen of the Year, Dr. Larry L. Nash. His son, Todd, will accept the award.
Well, thank you. And so, surprise, Dad. I guess we're trying to Skype this or something. And so I'm sure some 15-year-old set Dad up with some technology tonight in the clubhouse down in California. But congratulations, Dad. And it's kind of fun to hear some of the history of how I grew up. And I can tell you there was a lot of behind-the-scenes fun had right before the New Year or the Christmas Eve parade. I think they had a lot of fun building that sleigh every year, from what I understand. So some of you may know that he's unable to make it due to some health issues, but you know, and he's doing really well, so thanks for all your thoughts. But if he were here, I'm sure he'd say, you know, it's an honor and a privilege to receive such an award. And giving back to a community that has given him so much over the years is just something he really enjoys doing. And if you haven't noticed, he does love to reconstruct and construct things, whether it's barns or trails or bridges or even teeth, for that matter, in his day. But you also can, some of you can attest, he's pretty good at it too. And I've joked with him in his retirement years because I can't get on his calendar. His community calendar is so busy. And I, like him, likes to construct things, whether it's on our farm or on my acreage. And I always have a project list. So, Dad, I've got a lumber list, and I need you this summer. So I know he's excited to get back and get back on the community calendar and get back with all of you. So, again, it's an honor to accept this award on my dad's behalf. Thank you very much.
So good evening. I had a cowboy hat when I got here, but it blew away when we were in the parking lot warming up the drum line. I have my name and phone in it, Well, it's okay, but I had my name. I'm waiting on my hat because I had my name and phone in it, number in it. So I'm hoping somebody from Lockridge calls me soon with it. So I'm just waiting on that. So good evening. I'm Jim Edgton, and I have the honor tonight to pass on the torch of Citizen of the Year. It's been a pleasure serving for a year. I kept waiting to get called out like, Miss Universe, Miss America does, but nobody ever called me to go anyplace and open up a thing or cut ribbons or anything. But there's still time, I think. But and Jim Saltz and I have been trying really hard to represent the position of good citizens the best we could over the past year. Our record's been pretty good, though. Between the two of us, 6 arrests, no convictions. That's actually a quote from the upcoming high school play, Guys and Dolls, so just a plug there. So the story's really not true. I haven't been arrested at all. Tonight I get to introduce a person who was nominated for the 2016 Citizen of the Year in honor of their continued volunteer service to our community over many decades. This person is an outstanding example of a community member finding various niches in town and focusing on how to make our community a better place to raise a family and live a full, diverse life. One of the nominating letters describes this person's creative ability and boundless energy for so many causes and activities, along with being a perfect combination of can-do attitude, roll-up-your-sleeve action, vast local knowledge, and responsible leadership. They also stated that she has a playful sense of humor and puts her co-workers at ease. The letter goes on to state, calling her a friend is a great honor. Her dedication and efforts make her a shining star in our community. Excuse me. Her leadership and intelligence is an example to us all. Another nominating letter states, I've always known her to be one to jump in and volunteer in whatever situation she is in. Among friends in any group, PEO, or large group event, she's always organizing the collecting of clothing, food, money, or helps a sick friend get to Iowa City, or takes food to a neighbor. Our next COI, I coined that phrase, I don't know if it's a... Our next COI made her first connections with Fairfield way back on January 15th, 19 year withheld. And when she was born in Jefferson County Hospital to the parents of Richard and Marlis Adam. Yes, our little Nancy is truly an example of grow local. She grew up being the middle child of 7 on a farm just out southwest of our fair suburb of Packwood. She graduated from the University of Northern Iowa with a degree in art education. She completed her college education in just 3 years, graduating with honors. She became a district supervisor for Seifert Stores with direct supervision of 22 stores in 5 states. Somewhere along the way, she married Jim Horace. I think she was the only volunteer for that. She now works pretty much full-time for the citizens of Fairfield and Jefferson County. Working for you and me is how she has spent most of her life. Working for this community is how all of us have seen her over the past many decades. Here's a few more examples. During her 3 children's formative years, Mackenzie, Natalie, and Vincent, she was a Daisy and Brownie leader, hosted many athletic team meals, and organized and ran many fundraising auctions for the Trojan Booster Club. She's made baskets for numerous chocolate sundaes, volunteered for many theater productions, and worked on homecoming floats. She was a member of the Tuesday Morning Club. It was a teacher's auxiliary group at Washington Elementary School, where she helped decorate classrooms, coordinate events, read to groups of children, and chaperone trips. Along with her volunteering for educational causes, Nancy also has given endless hours of service to many other organizations throughout the community. Here's some other examples of her outstanding volunteer record. She served as president of the Fairfield Golf and Country Club. She volunteers as decorator and event planning for the club. She also volunteers as a decorator and event planner for the Fairfield Arts and Convention Center. She served and worked on the Partners for Play Playground Committee, where she created the history wall. If you haven't seen that there, it's a wall that with carefully created community landmarks that were made out of wood by hand. She's painted and decorated the Santa House on the square inside and out for many holidays and has created gingerbread houses for the Chamber of Commerce. She's worked with the Habitat for Humanity, where she painted and decorated a playhouse for one of their projects. She served on the building committee for the new St. Mary's Catholic Church, where her sense of art and design were used for the structure, interior, and stained glass windows. She also has taught 4th and 10th grade education classes at St. Mary's, and she has served as a member of the Greater Jefferson County Foundation, serving as finance chair, executive board member, and high school scholarship committee member. She's well known as a driving member of the Fairfield Art Association. Serving as president for many years, she founded the annual art camp for children, not only organizing the summer event for many years, but also teaching at the camp. She selected the design, fundraised for, and organized the installation of the mural inside the Aquatic Center at Roosevelt. Nancy's probably best known right now for her service to the community as a charter member of the Fairfield Beautification Committee. As chairman, she is in charge of the budget and the communication with the City Council. Even though she may be chairperson, it's not uncommon to see her personally stringing holiday lights, pulling weeds, planting flowers downtown and in front of Chautauqua Park. She waters plants, she decorates pots, and she paints banners. We see her honoring local businesses and individuals who have helped better our community by making Fairfield a more beautiful place. Nancy's well known for her use of famous quotes, according to one of her friends. When life gets overwhelming for some, you may hear her say, "Life by the yard is hard, but life by the inch is a cinch." Or when leading a tough meeting discussion with various opinions, you will hear her say, "Only a fool can't change their mind." Well, Nancy, I have a quote for you from Booker T. Washington. "In proportion as one renders service, she becomes great." Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you Fairfield Citizen of the Year for 2016, Nancy Horace.
I'm really overwhelmed by this. I don't know who came up with this, but there's so many other people that could have had this besides me. But thank you very much for honoring me like this. And I think I've had a lot of good fortune and support from a lot of people. Parents who were very hard workers, good Germans, Karin, and then from there, I had lots of great mentors along the way and a lot of support from a lot of friends, including a lot of you that are in this room. So thank you very much.
What a great honor for both of them. In closing, it's the part where you've been waiting for. Please notice on your table, there are tents, I've been told. Actually, I like to refer to them as teepees, that list all the sponsors for tonight's awards. Thank them. Well, thank all of the sponsors tonight. And I thank all the committees that made this meeting possible. And thank you again, Nancy, for your 23 years of service to the Chamber. Thank all of you for attending. And remember, don't go where the path may lead. Go instead to where there's no path and leave a trail. 'Cause if you're not making dust, you're eating it. Have a good night and adios.